is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air.
Honey, instead of watching TV again tonight, how about we do something to spice up our relationship?
Okay. What did you have in mind?
Well, I went to our favorite romance boutique and I bought us some sex games.
So, this looks like a much more interesting set of playful games that focus a bit more on foreplay. So I noticed with the lover lust, we decide which one of us wants to be love and which wants to be lust, or we could both be one or the other. What would you like to be, Emily?
I think I will be lust.
Well then, I will be love, just to be different. And so we move around the board, doing different foreplay actions with each other. So I have the white marker, and I start with compliment your lover, because the love is all about loving your partner. You have the most beautiful smile, and now you roll the die.
All right.
And you get to spank me.
Oh, baby.
Woo. Spicy. I now feed you an edible treat.
Oh.
Wow. So we return to having an edible treat for you.
Oh, thank you.
Your roll.
Oh, thanks. Oh.
You have a one. So you get to have a card from the love stack, which is basically a question like, where do I prefer to make love? So it's more conversational. And so basically, I would guess your answer, or you would try to get the point correct so that you could win the card. So I answer the question, but you have to tell me where you think I would prefer to make love.
Okay.
So if I had to pick just a fantasy place, where do you think it would be?
On the beach.
That's true. So you get to keep the card and you get to continue playing. Now, if you didn't get it right, you would start over because you'll see it's a very quick game board.
Okay.
And now I talk dirty. You're a little filthy.
Aww.
So that's basically how the game's played. So we collect the cards, and basically when you reach true love or true lust, then you get to decide which of the cards you're going to act out. That seems
exciting.
Like a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Now we have the lust game, where basically you have foreplay. It's like the sex games that we had, only you have sex positions that you earn and you collect a collection of the sex positions, but along the way we have different foreplay squares. So sensuality, so sometimes a little naughty can be a great way to get you and your lover in the mood. Tell your lover exactly what you would like to do to him or her in a seductive manner using dirty talk you're both comfortable with. If this turns you on, award yourself one lovemaking card. So then you earn the sex position cards from the lust. And so basically, as we move around the board, you have a lot of chances to earn the different cards. And then you also have romance. Reminisce with your lover about a recent time you felt incredibly loved and appreciated by her or him. And then body language. Massage your lover's feet for a few minutes. Use your lover's reactions and the feelings of his or her feet to identify the areas most of in need of attention. Be sure to spend a little extra time on these areas. So each of them have text descriptions that allow us, as we move around the board, to knock all the other games over. To figure out, you know, just different ways to communicate with each other. So it offers a lot of good foreplay, it looks like. And a lot of content in here. I mean, there's 20 of each of those cards and 20 lovemaking cards to go along with the game pieces that we would use to move around the board. And last but not least of this little collection, we have Let's Fool Around and the Let's Fool Around cards. So the dice we use and it can be the two of us, or it can be several players, where you end up basically, you know, bringing other people in if you want. So, we have our friend here that could join in if we like.
Hello!
And then with the cards, we can play just the two of us, or we can add extra people as well. This can be played with up to four people or team, so we could play with several couples.
Ooh.
But it could just be a party game, because you decide if what you're going to do to what person. So, if I was uncomfortable maybe kissing somebody else, or some of these things are as crazy as suck penis or clitoris, I might choose to do something else like suck your face or your inner thighs. Or I might be curious to explore a little bit with Jacob over here.
Ooh.
With the cards, then you have certain things like offer a lap dance where they have a $100 tip. So then the person decides like who you would do that with. So it can be a party game so we can get our friends to flirt together, maybe find a girlfriend for Jacob, or experiment with him. Whatever the mood takes us.
Oh,